Well, tonight, more than a dozen women who were taking part in a program to turn their lives around are out on the streets, evicted after the group helping them didn't pay the rent. ABC 7's DC Bureau Chief Sam Ford joins us from Southeast with their story tonight. Sam?
Allison, for 2 years, this building at 21st and Minnesota Southeast had been a group home for women on parole. Women today were scattered about the city, at school, and at work when U.S. Marshals showed up and put the group home's belongings out on Minnesota Avenue. At one point this afternoon, the stuff took up half the block. Desks, chairs, mattresses, trash bags, items out of a building where a group home for parolees had just been evicted.
We had an agreement with the landlord to move, and he violated the agreement.
Sharon Anderson calls her program Way of the Word. She says she housed 15 women who were getting their lives together by working or going to school and living here with counselors to help them. One was at school this morning.
They called and said we had to get home. We were being evicted.
It's like it hurts because I don't have a place to stay, and I was getting my life together. And it's like, it's a setback name because I don't know what's the next step.
DC's federally funded program, CSOSA, contracted with the group home to house the women. The building's landlord is not apologizing for this eviction.
She hasn't paid us any rent, the owners any rent on this building since August. She's in arrears since August of 2012, which is kind of disheartening knowing, you know, all the money that the federal government is providing to house these people.
It really didn't have to happen like this.
Obviously, a lot of questions will have to be answered about what happened here. Police stayed on the scene to keep the thieves away, and the group home was able to remove all of its property. We spoke by phone with a spokesperson for CSOSA, the parole agency, who said that all of the residents here had been gathered up and taken to other facilities. Reporting live from Southeast Washington, Sam Ford, ABC 7 News. Thanks.